Hi everyone, so this video is for the YouTube Artist Collective, and if you don't know what that is, the YouTube Artist Collective is a group of YouTube artists, and every few months we all get together and draw something, all relating to the same theme. And the themes are actually chosen by all of you. On our Facebook group, we post a poll with theme suggestions, and then you all vote on them, and whatever wins, we all pick that theme, and then we make a drawing related to the theme. So if you want to see any of the other members that are in the collective, I'll put all of their links in the description. We have guest members this time too, so please check out the guest members. And the theme this time was World in a Bottle. And I was really excited about this theme for a long time because it was in the poll a few times, but it hadn't won before. But this time, World in a Bottle won. And when I heard that it won, I was really excited about it. And when I started working on it, I thought since it was World in a Bottle, it would be a pretty open-ended theme. But as I was sketching, it seemed a little bit limiting to me almost. Like, I know you can do any world you want inside the bottle, but the thing that I found lim like I kind of limited myself by drawing a bottle first and then, okay, what am I going to put inside the bottle? And I just like kept drawing the bottle the same way, and like just the fact that there had to be a bottle, that was kind of throwing me a little bit, and I just like couldn't think outside the box sort of thing. Like, I couldn't think of what to put inside the bottle and what kind of bottle I wanted and all that. But I thought of this idea. You know that, I don't know if this is necessarily called a trope, or it's just something you see a lot in shows, or just like it's just like a common idea of a cat like staring at a fishbowl because cats eat fish. So I kind of reversed the roles here where the cat is inside the bottle and the fish are swimming around it, watching the cat. So it's almost like world outside a bottle, and like the cat is inside, isolated. That was my idea here. And I don't know, like, this seems like, when I say it out loud, it seems like something that's definitely probably been done before, but that's what I thought of. And I decided to do it digitally because we're allowed to now, and I really want to work on my digital art. It's my favorite medium next to watercolor. So digital art is like, I always really enjoy it, and I just like the fact that you can change it as much as you want. But that can also kind of be a curse at the same time because you can just keep zooming in and keep adding details, and because you can change everything, you tend to get a little bit perfectionistic about it. So I decided to do a simple bottle, just like a round one with a cork in it. I didn't want to have it with a cork out of it because then the cat would drown. And I know that the bottle is technically full of air for the cat, so it shouldn't be sinking, but I just figured it's being held on the bottom somehow. I don't know how, but like it's just there somehow. And I wanted to make the fish orange because I just really like drawing orange fish. I know it's really popular to do, but orange fish, it just went well with the blue water. I think that's like it goes well with the water, but I think it's a really popular overdone sort of thing. But I wanted to draw orange fish, and I couldn't decide what color I wanted the cat to be. Because I didn't want the cat to match the fish. Like, I didn't want the hue of the cat to be the same as the fish because it would feel kind of flat, I think, if he was the same. But I still wanted him to be brown, and like brown is like a desaturated sort of orangey red color. I think I ended up making it kind of similar to the fish, but then I put a blue transparent sort of layer over top of the cat to make it look like it's in the water, or like it's in the bottle, but there's water in front of it, so it kind of has like a blue tint to it. Something I tried to remember to do with this painting was to not overwork it, because looking back at all my digital paintings, I'm pretty sure I overworked a lot of them because I wanted to add little details everywhere, but I've been learning a lot that you only really want there to be tons of detail in the part of the picture that's important, because if you put something really, really detailed in the background or off in the corner, it's not going to sit back the way you want it to. So you want the details to be where the focus is. So the focus is on the cat and the bottle and kind of the three fish circling around the bottle. That's where I wanted the focus to be. So I tried to add detail to those, and I tried to make the other fish duller and blend back, sit back more, and blend in with the background. So I made them bluer and not as much detail. So I was really trying to keep that in mind. I was trying to think really hard before I put every brush stroke down for this one. And I think it worked out. I wouldn't call it completely finished. I think it's resolved in the sense that the colors and the lighting are where I want them to be, but I don't think it's as detailed as it could be, and I don't think it's as clean as it could be. Like, I don't want it to be super clean, but I think I could add more detail to the rocks, or I could just add a little bit more plants or maybe some more fish in the background. I don't know, but I wanted to leave it this way because I was happy with it, and it's resolved, like I said, in the sense that all the lighting and all the colors are where I wanted them to be and where they should be. So it's pretty much done. I'm always hesitant to call something done because I might look at it a week from now and notice a bunch of things about it that I want to fix. So that's another thing about painting, because when you finish something, you don't really know what it looks like. You do, but it's helpful to not see it for a long time and then look at it again, especially from a distance with just like a fresh set of eyes, and just see what it looks like. And it'll look different too. You'll notice things that you didn't notice before that you want to fix. So I might wait and do that. I always say this, though. I always say I'm gonna add some more things to this drawing, and then I never do. And not everything has to be fully finished and cleaned up and polished. Not everything has to be that way, because sometimes that's not like the most important thing about a picture. The most important thing is like the meaning and making sure that it all works together. I'm also always worried about making things too simple, like not giving them enough things that make them look complicated. For instance, in this one, I'm feeling kind of bad about the way I drew the bottle because I just made it completely flat on. Like, you don't it's not at an angle. Like, it's completely, like, the bottle looks really flat in my opinion because I made the corkscrew just like face up. If you know what I mean, like the opening of the bottle isn't on an angle. It's not pointing towards you or away. It's like straight flat, like parallel to your eyes, I guess. I don't know how to explain, but I think you know what I mean. And I don't know if that's a good or bad thing. I should have played with more angles for the bottle. That's kind of a regret I have with this drawing. And also, I just somehow feel like there's not enough going on in the picture, but I don't know if that's just me feeling like I need to put detail into everything and show my full potential and everything, because I don't think everything needs tons of detail. I think simple things can work well too. I just don't know. I'm just overthinking it. It's fine. I'm happy with it. I wanted to share what I actually thought about it. So I hope you enjoyed seeing me paint these fish and this cat sitting in the bottle. I'm overall happy with the way it turned out, but like I said, I haven't really waited a long time and then looked at it like a week later yet, so I don't know how I really feel. And also, make sure you check out all the other artists in the YouTube Artist Collective. Everything will be linked in the description to go see their channels. So make sure you check out their videos and also the guest artists as well, because we have guest artists every time. And it's really cool to see how other people interpret the theme. So that's what I'm excited about, because you can literally take World in a Bottle and do that. But you can also kind of twist it to the way you want it to work. Like, I did World outside a bottle sort of thing. Like the cat's in the bottle, but the world is outside. So I really hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in my next video.